What's best, bus or train? Well, do you know, that's a question I've not asked before here on the channel. So today, we're going to take a trip from here in Edinburgh across to Glasgow on a Megabus bus. And we're going to come back from Glasgow to Edinburgh on a Scotrail train. And we're going to compare the two. Which do you think will win? Welcome to St Andrew Square here in the centre of Edinburgh, and we're just a minute's walk away from Edinburgh Bus Station. If you watch the channel regularly, you know that I'm a bit of a transport geek, but I must admit my favourites are aeroplanes, trains and boats. I've never really been a massive fan of buses, and I'm not actually quite sure why. Anyway, recently Mrs. E said to me, you need to get yourself onto more buses. So I thought I'd start with an easy trip from Edinburgh to Glasgow return. There on the bus, back on the train. Just see how we get on. Well, if you fancy grabbing yourself a coffee before the trip on the bus, there is a cafe in the bus station, but to be perfectly honest, because St Andrew Square is just a minute's walk away from the bus station, I'd be tempted to get a coffee from this coffee shop here and actually sit outside if you've got a bit of time to kill before your bus. Right, let's head into the bus station. Oh, looks like we're going down into the depths. There you go, that's the cafe I told you about. I would still stick with that one in St Andrew Square. I love that bus stations have gates, just like airports. And today we're leaving from Gate A. Got to admit, I've not really much clue about the manufacturers of buses. If it was a plane, I could tell you whether it was an A320 or a Boeing 737. If it was a train, I could tell you whether it was a Class 800 or a Class 385. But with buses, it's completely over the top of my head. I booked using the Megabus website. The gate departure board says it's a Citylink service, but the bus itself is actually Stagecoach, so I've really no idea who I'm travelling with. Let's go get on board. The seats are laid out 2x2 as you would expect. And there does seem to be a bit of built-in recline to them. Yep, the headrest is soft and some decent lumbar support. All important base. Yep, lots of cushioning there. Quite soft, in fact. It's hot on this bus, but there's no cool air coming out of these vents. This seat pitch is really, really tight. And as you can see, there's not really that much room to spread out. But there are two USB charging sockets down below. To be honest, I wasn't expecting a double-decker bus. And so the views from the top deck are actually pretty impressive. Wow, We are well on our way to Glasgow now, and I have to say, this Megabus Citylink Stagecoach bus is actually quite comfortable. Admittedly, the seat pitch is a little bit tight. It's what you would expect on a really low-cost airline, and there isn't actually a tray table. So had I had a laptop and a gigantic cup of coffee, I'd have been in trouble, but it's an hour and a half's journey, so it's not bad at all. Have to say though, on YouTube I've seen better buses from other companies, ones with leather seats, ones with tray tables. I don't even think there's Wi-Fi on this bus. Welcome to Glasgow. Here we are in Glasgow, and that is Buchanan Bus Station. So here's the lowdown on that Megabus Citylink Stagecoach trip over from Edinburgh. It cost me £6.40. Now, let's face it, that's pretty good, isn't it? That's hardly the cost of a couple of coffees. The journey time, 90 minutes for the 50 or so miles between Edinburgh and Glasgow. So not too shabby a travel time there. Okay, so we've done the bus. Let's go and get the train. But actually, before we get the train, there's a couple of things I want to show you here in Glasgow. I've always been a massive Doctor Who fan, and you know, Glasgow is one of the only places in the UK where they still have genuine, genuine police boxes on the street. Can you see the difference with this one though? It's red, and most of them these days have been turned into coffee kiosks. Well, there's a blue one, a genuine, genuine 1950s police box here on the streets of Glasgow. Of course it's a TARDIS. But wouldn't it be great if we could pop inside and set the controls and dematerialise and be home in a flash? But we've got to go on the train, so let's head to Glasgow Queen Street Station. Over the last few years, Queen Street Station has undergone a massive, massive refurbishment. So on the outside, it looks absolutely nothing like it did 5 years ago. So I'm really interested to see what it's like inside. Inside, and this new facade is really impressive, isn't it? Really open and spacious. But if you look carefully up there above the announcements board, you can see the old roof of the old station dating back way into the 1800s. There you go, you can see it a bit better in this shot. Well, I'm really impressed with this refurbished Glasgow Queen Street station. Should have said, the bus this morning was absolutely bang on time, so I'm hoping that Scotrail will similarly oblige us this afternoon. So let's go and get on board our Class 385. See, I knew the type of the train. Couldn't have told you the type of the bus this morning. Let's head to Edinburgh.
Service to Edinburgh. Calling out to join.
Our class 385 today is in fact two units stuck together. So two units of four making a total of eight carriages. So a really long train between Glasgow and Edinburgh today. Let's get on board. These seats are really quite hard. There's very little padding on the back, and at the bottom, my goodness, solid. But there is free Wi-Fi. Is actually quite comfortable. Now the seats seem to be a little bit hard at first. In fact, you saw me give it the thump test, but the shape is correct, so it actually doesn't feel too uncomfortable. Much better than the seats on some trains that you can find in the UK at the moment. So I'm going to sit back, relax, and enjoy the scenery between here and Edinburgh. Edinburgh Waverley, bang on time. And after another swift little journey on another commuter train, I'm nearly back home. So here is the lowdown on that trip from Glasgow to Edinburgh on that class 385. It cost me £14.70 and the journey time was 49 minutes. So double the price, more than double the price of the bus, but half the time spent. So which was best? Well, to be perfectly honest, I guess it depends upon whether you're looking to save money or whether you're time poor. If you've got the time and you want to save a bit of money, you can't go wrong between Edinburgh and Glasgow for £6.40, can you? I mean, that's an absolute bargain. But if you're in a hurry, I just found all of that hanging about in traffic like you would do if you were in a car, although the bus lanes do help. Hanging around in all that traffic, and we came off the motorway a few times to go to a bus stop in the middle of an industrial estate where nobody got on or nobody got off, so that felt a little bit tedious. Whereas on the train, you just power right through, stop at the stations, and within 49 minutes, you're there. So I actually enjoyed the bus in terms of comfort. Wasn't that much different to the train, maybe a little bit less legroom, but the seats were very, very similar. So I think in future, I might be tempted to try a few more bus journeys, but I really want to try ones with leather seats and air conditioning and Wi-Fi. So do tell me in the comments which bus companies I should be trying. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe to the YouTube channel. Until the next one, remember, there's always something to see. So get out there and find it.
Oh.